it's me, and I'm at home in my kitchen, and I just want to say a huge thank you to everyone who tuned in last week for my Halloween extravaganza. You'll be pleased to hear I'm feeling a lot better now. And don't worry if you think that pumpkins are just for Halloween, they're not. And I'm going to show you something delicious. I'm going to show you how to make a pumpkin cheesecake brownie. Let's go. The first thing you need to do is melt some chocolate and butter together, and I've got 230 grams of dark chocolate with 120 grams of unsalted butter just chopped up straight from the fridge, and I'm just going to melt that together gently over a bain-marie. So once that's all melted, it's going to need to cool down before you use it, so just pop it to one side and we'll get on with something else. So the next thing we need to make is the pumpkin cheesecake topping. So grab a little bowl in front of you and a whisk, and then I've got 115 grams of pureed pumpkin straight out of a can. And then I've got 115 grams of cream cheese, which I've softened to room temperature. And I've got 2 tablespoons of caster sugar as well. And I've got 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon and 1/2 teaspoon of ground ginger. And then I'm gonna grate some fresh nutmeg in as well using my tiny little grater. So you're gonna need about 1/2 teaspoon of that. And then just 1 large free-range egg in there as well. And then just whisk it up with a whisk. Once that's all smooth, just pop it to one side, and now we're gonna get on with making the brownie batter. So for that, you're going to need 150 grams of caster sugar and 60 grams of light soft brown sugar and 1 teaspoon of vanilla. And 3 large free-range eggs. And then just pop that on to a medium speed and beat it together until it's all really nicely combined. So it's been mixing for about 1 minute now and it looks pretty good. It's a little bit paler. And now I need to add 100 grams of plain flour, to which I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder, and just using my little whisk, just mix that together. And once that's all really well mixed, you just need quite a generous pinch of salt. Just put that in as well. Give it a little mix. And by now your chocolate mixture should be nice and cool and ready to use. So pop that to one side, get your chocolate mixture back. I'm just gonna pour it in while the mix is going. So just put it on a minimum speed first and pour it in. So let that mix completely until it's all really well combined, just for a few seconds, and then stop it, and it's time to put your dry ingredients in. So grab your bowl and just whack it in. And that's almost ready. Now there's one last thing to put in, and that is chocolate chips. So I've got 100 grams of milk chocolate chips. I've just used a bar of chocolate, which I've chopped up, but you can just use chocolate chips or whatever you have around. And just fold that really briefly, just for a few seconds, but not too much. That's enough. So that is your chocolate brownie batter, and it looks amazing. So now I just need to get that off the paddle. And I've got an 8x8 inch tin here, which I've lined, greased and lined with baking parchment. And I'm just gonna pour all of that in. And just using your spatula or a palette knife, just level that off a little bit. So that is gonna be a delicious brownie, regardless of what you do next, but this won't be a pumpkin cheesecake brownie without the pumpkin cheesecake. So back to your pumpkin mixture, and grab a spoon and just dollop blobs of it all over the top of your brownie. And then using just a regular butter knife, just wiggle that around, making swirly patterns all the way through. So once you've got enough swirls, you just need to bake it. And I'm gonna bake mine at 170 degrees Celsius for about 40 minutes. Check it at 38, just stick a cocktail stick right in the middle and it wants to come out with a little bit of batter on, just a few crumbs, because you don't wanna overdo it, otherwise it'll be dry. Thanks to the magic of YouTube, my brownie is out of the oven and is completely cool. So now all I need to do is take it out of the tin and chop it into bite-sized pieces so I can eat it quicker. Look at that. Look at that lovely fudgy brownie with all the chocolate chips inside and this delicious sweet pumpkin cheesecake bit. That is... So that was my pumpkin cheesecake brownie. Give it a go at home. Let me know how you get on in the comments box below. And if you like this video and you want to see more videos by me, then subscribe to my channel by clicking on the link up there. And I will see you next week for another brilliant recipe. And until then, I'm gonna get busy with this guy. See you then, bye.